Over the years, cults have managed to foster increasingly negative criticism about themselves. They have gained the fame of being disturbed groups of people who are brainwashed into believing something illogical and may become aggressive, delusional, and suicidal. But what is a cult, really? Webster's Dictionary describes a cult as a great devotion to a person, idea, object, movement, or work. So logically, not all cults are irrational and suicidal. But cults get a bad reputation because they are often violent and suicidal, and their leaders are quick to exploit members for personal pleasure. There have been many cases of cult violence, mass suicides, and even statutory rape of girls as young as 10 years old. But how do the leaders get away with it all? Why do these people continue to follow leaders? Because cult leaders have one very special tactic against their followers, and that is brainwashing. I know it all sounds very dramatic in science fiction, but that's the honest answer. Cult groups use brainwashing to control and recruit their members. The question now is, how exactly do you brainwash someone? It all starts off with the leader. The leader is the most important person of a cult. They decide what the cult believes in and what the rules are. The cult leader maintains power by convincing members that he is the only form of authority in their lives. The leader can achieve this by specifying precise rules, controlling the communication between members, and punishing members that break the group rules. The key to a successful leadership is behind the rules, which are designed to benefit the leader and justify their tyrant power in the group. In the long run, the group leaders actually cause followers to become tolerant to their own exploitation. When recruiting, new members are quick to form strong bonds with the long-term members. This allows the cult members to peek into the recruitees' lives and collect any form of information they can about each new member, like feelings of guilt, past mistakes, weaknesses, insecurities, and unhappiness in their lives. The group's mission during recruiting is to make the new members believe that the group will help solve their problems and relieve feelings of guilt or self-doubt. Once in the group, acceptance of the rules and ideology are important for friendships, but in time, they become the key to survival. Members are in a constant pressure to prove their commitment and belief in the group in order to avoid physical or psychological punishment. This can involve anything from hard labor, public humiliation, rejection, or even physical abuse. Members are also pressured to conform to the leader's needs, which might require them to show commitment by rejecting outside family and friends, giving up outside jobs, or donating financial assets to the group. You can think of brainwashing as an advertisement, like a door-to-door salesman selling a product to the homeowner. The brainwashing methods of cults are very subtle, and when recruiting, the recruiters insist to try it out, as if joining a cult could be a limited-time thing. The key to this sale is to overwhelm the listener with good word of the cult and continually pressure them into making a decision before they are able to look at the situation from all possible angles. But unlike a salesman, the cultist is interested in the person behind the buyer. They want to sit down with an interested individual and get to know them and tell them about the program by including vocabulary that relates to God. This way, they can make the person feel as if they have to join the cult, or they will later face the wrath of God. Often, the cult leader is trying to brainwash himself as well, and let himself know that what he is doing is right. There is a certain feeling of guilt at times, and to avoid this, the leader must step back and convince himself that what he is doing is righteous, that he is leading a group of people towards the correct path, and that other religions and beliefs are wrong.